that he just went off stage more.
Whoa, dude, you're cursing?
Joking. So, like, you were real, like, aware that he was coming off stage, you just let it happen. And I don't blame you, it's very hard to react to that type of stuff, because it happens all the time. Yeah, you see my brother after.
I feel very much. No, I totally expected the ball to just stop it.
Yeah, me too. It did.
You don't want some hot chips and cheese, dude.
Seen that. The ball is better than the Gordo.
It is.
You're a little confused. You're a little like, what the hell
just
happened?
Oh, my bad. Wait, I'm gonna update the bracket, guys. Sorry about that.
My little brother's new baby.
Stop battle!
This is a spike ball. Spike ball was
good. Yoshi!
Why? No, why? It's a blade beam! The ball went through the blade beam, like, it didn't even
matter. 3, 2, 1, go!
No, it's a blade beam. It's a terrible.
Oh boy, we're starting. Okay, I completely missed out.
I was talking to Young God Static. In this game, I know Commander just doesn't like the Ingen versus Yoshi matchup.
Why? So
because Ingen struggles to kill, and he feels like Chaos is one of those guys that you just can't kill for some reason at high percent. So you want to make those hits that you do get count. You're like, whoa. Ooh, Commander opted to try and punish that parry with a... Well, his... Try to do the parry after jump time, it didn't work out. But see, making the hits count.
It was a good back there. And it's kind of weird. Every time I see Dave off in the brain, I kind of feel like he's kind of like that top down. I was really sad that he didn't get to see City. I was really curious to see the run between him and Zhao. I don't think we've seen them play against each other.
Not here, down in the valley, but they have played each other. And J-Boss has taken it over
this Gale. Season.
Yes. He has taken it over Gale. He is a very good player. J-Boss has a lot of notable wins, a lot of out-of-state wins. He has beaten Mega Fox. So J-Boss is one of those good players. But like I said, Commander is just using the character that he feels comfortable with in Wolf. Getting those hits that count. Yes.
No, sorry. Just winners using
Play top 3.
I feel like the way Commander's gonna get J-Boss up third is if he goes for that grab. If you can get, if you can go for this grab right now, it'd be very good because you put Yoshi in a very tough position. That's it. J-Boss is all he needs. Commander was committed to go on that laser, and J-Boss just scouted that out and he was like, you know what, I'm just gonna go up there, get this stock, and I'm gonna try my best to just get back on this lead. Very good from J-Boss. With those shades, help out Commander Rock, and now he has to fight the neutral again.
Yeah.
Nice edge. It does cover a lot of J-Boss's options. Like, hey, you know, now you have to be careful with this edge. Let me recover. No, and Yoshi's just such a good character. Like, it's very hard to get in on Yoshi and making hits now, because he has a lot of good moves, such as like his Nair.
185, full no kill. So like in this scenario, let's see, Commander, because I feel like Commander's character is more huge, right? How do you approach J-Boss? Because J-Boss, you're winning right here, yet you can feel like you're down, like you're under pressure. Like, how do players feel when J-Boss is actually entering? When I see him here, I come to him, it's like, this guy's already top 2 or anything.
Well, a lot of the times, to answer that question, when you're a top player in the team for a very long time, it's just that signal where like, oh, I'm the bottom of the player, like, yeah. I need to close it out. And, you know, a lot of times that mentality is very hard to keep. You know, you do stuff that you just want to do because you want to kill. It comes back to fight you. The Commander's not a player about that. He understands that he's also himself a top player. And if anything, he's probably arguably top 3 as well. But him and Commander, I think, very close to each other's levels towards the end of Smash 4. They were doubles partners and they ended up being like almost rivals, I would say.
Yeah, and this is really exciting to see how Commander did practice always just instead of keep getting it to play. So I feel like this is his redemption arc, where he gets to try out his skills that he got to practice his whole time. And that's what it's gonna be. It's gonna take game one.
You know, it's gonna be very interesting to see how J-Boss adapts. Exactly what to do, game two. But I would like to see more from Commander, just be a little bit more aggressive. He was playing super patient and he was letting J-Boss make the mistakes. I would like to see that game two switch it up, be aggressive. And if it doesn't pan out, just revert to what was working. You know, you don't fix what's not broken.
Yeah. Oh my god, can someone turn off the TV? Do you ever get annoyed about like the, like, you know how like you come to these tournaments and like people just leave the
menus?
Yeah, dude, it gets so annoyed by it.
I don't know about everything.
Dude, like, you have to.
I get annoyed when people just leave a character just staring at me for a long time. I hate Corona.
When they just like leave, like pick a character, but like they're not sure if they're gonna play it or they're just doing it.
So here we at game two. Obviously, go to Yoshi's Island. This is arguably one of the Yoshi's better stages because it's just a lot more better. You can do a lot more, juggles, a lot more mix-ups that they have to fill out. Down to up airs, neutral air. Neutral is pretty well. That egg misses a lot. I feel like Wolf does benefit more from the stage than Yoshi, but we'll like to see how it plays out. I do. Okay, they're requiring now playing Smashville. I hate Smashville. It's incredibly tiny. You can barely move around on it. And any movement kind of like leads to an outcome, even if you don't intend it to. Well, the stage is arguably smaller. And right now, we do see J-Boss trying to finish this with an egg to like up there. Commander going for the hardest freeze, thinking that J-Boss is gonna block dodge, but J-Boss is the better player. He's like, hey, you know, I'm not gonna throw out that option, I'm not gonna do three.
Yeah.
Ooh, very interesting interaction too. Commander is not opting to like try and punish it and get the stock off.
That was really smart as to how he would cover that, and that's even smarter deciding to go for. Yeah, that's a neutral, right?
I was down there. But Wolf, can Wolf,
I think Wolf grabs onto Log. Can you do that?
I don't know.
Or was it just a weird interaction that I saw?
It might have been a weird interaction. But nonetheless, Commander's definitely can pull this off. Definitely just like take this game, take this set. He does have the lead, and Wolf is making this game down.
When it comes to like frame data and like stats,
Yoshi's better.
If you like look them up, like,
no.
As to like how into data are you like, when you're playing the game?
When I'm playing the game, I am aware of how fast the moves come out, and I am very adept in my character. So it's very important to keep knowing your data about a character, and just about any other characters in general. Like, just knowing that, hey, this move is actually pretty slow, or I can actually take this person out of this move, is very important, and that can win you a lot of stuff.
Because I think there's some moves that just look differently than what their data says. So it's always very interesting.
And when I
saw
your
moves,
I'm like, okay,
you know, like, one of the moves that is like that is, I want to say like, Yoshi's up there. Not up here, I'm sorry, up tilt. It just doesn't scoop you, it hits you from the behind. So if he throws a up tilt, like, in front of you,
oh, yeah.
That can hit you.
Oh my
very
goodness,
good
confirm,
my commander.
Because I've never seen
Manor took it!
Alright, and I'm gonna stop.